I hope everybody understands the story, right? If we don't dream big and we don't really believe in ourselves and we have the heart of a mouse, there's really very little you can do. So look to yourself and say, I want the heart of a lion, right? I want to dream big. I want to get out there and achieve, and I want to go and do what I can do. So what I would say to you is, dream big, believe in yourself, and go out there and achieve it.
And then maybe one day, you know, because somebody put a fiver in or somebody put a tenner in and we were able to, a researcher was able to be hired, or a researcher was able to get the equipment that they needed to be successful in their research, and you know they found that cure, or they found something that you know radically changed how we treat cancer. Wouldn't that be amazing?
Well, my dad died of cancer about 8-9 months ago, so it had a huge impact. I mean, it was hard because, I mean, you know, you're losing someone who's so close to you. I mean, people say, well, I understand, but you really don't until you've been through it.
Two and a half years ago, my dad was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. It is hard. And I think sometimes it's in those quiet moments when you stop your mind from being so busy. You can distract yourself with lots of things, of course. And then when you give yourself the chance to think about it, you can only kind of go so far.
You know, we know people, loved ones that have been impacted by cancer, and we know the toll that it takes on a family, as well as the people that actually have the disease. And it's heartbreaking.
I was diagnosed with testicular cancer, and I'm cancer-free for 6 years. You know, it's certainly probably the toughest part of that period in my life was just actually making the little, I don't know, it's not quite an announcement, but it's you know, just saying, I think I have cancer, you know, and even saying, I think I have cancer, just softens it up a little bit, you know, but I have cancer would be something that I didn't say too often, because I saw that reaction I'd get from people and the emotions that it would kind of bring out in them, you know.
We're not just doing research for research sake, we're doing research to try and develop treatments to save people, save our loved ones and save ourselves. And the only way we're going to do that is we continue to invest in research. We get out there and we fundraise and we do things. We make sure resources isn't a reason that a phenomenal idea didn't get from a lab to the patient that needed it. And we all have a part to play in it. And I hope you'll join us.